Hey guys, Pyroblock here, and we're here with more Super Mario 64. Sorry I haven't recorded in a bit, didn't have the time, and yeah. And it sucks I didn't get new equipment, but kind of tight on money. But in this episode, I'm gonna get two caps, and I'm going to get a few secret stars and do a level. So hopefully this level, hopefully this episode will be a bit long, to make up for what you've missed. Too bad this game's a bit short. Oh well. Yeah, that was kind of random, but it doesn't matter. And I failed on that long jump with hesitating, because, really? Because I pulled back on the long jump, I wanted to land on it, and then, yeah, the rest is self-explanatory. Just, come on, it's not hard. There you go. Once you ground pound on those pillars, the lake in front of the castle drains, and you can go into an area right over here. And I am gonna cut to my successful attempt because I failed. Well, I'm gonna show this one first because it's the first try. This won't be in the bloopers because, can't die. Welcome to the Vanish Kept Switch Course. All the black blocks, blue blocks you find will become solid once you step on the cap switch. It will disappear when you put on the Vanish Cap. So you'll be able to elude enemies and walk through many things. Try it out. I recommend changing your camera angle to this so you can see all the red coins. It's just my preference. How the red coins are laid out, it's actually pretty simple to remember, but with how I'm doing this, I don't want to miss any, and I might have to restart. Nope, no, I'm good. Yeah, first four right here, and basically the failing shall start right now, because this is when I start messing up. It's very simple jumps, but let's play Curse. Gets me every time, especially that Bowser level. That was insane. Oh god, that I've never played this game like that before. That was ridiculous. God, I don't want to relive that moment, especially with that being one of the easiest Bowser levels. Oh god, that was close. Huh, I might be able to do this on my first try. Knowing me, I'm gonna jinx it, though. Whoa. That was, close, I guess. Wow, I did it on my first try. That's nice. Better than my first take, I'll tell you that. Which you guys will never see because the recording failed miserably. Oh, God! I thought I just fell through a hole. The camera angle was really bad. With how the camera angle was, it looked like I fell through a hole. I'm not kidding. Oh god, that scared me. Well, now we have 8 secret castle stars, and I'm gonna go to Big Boo's mansion. And is that the camera messing up, or is that my TV? Might be my TV, and that's not a good thing. So yeah, we're gonna go back to Big Boo's mansion. It's called Big Boo's Haunt, isn't it? Yeah, Big Boo's Haunt. Well, it's a mansion, so. Yeah. Same thing. Doesn't matter. Does it? No. No, it does not. Just because of that one level, I want to play Luigi's Mansion right now. I've never beaten it. Never have. Most likely never will. But with that cap, we can get the final star, and it's not that hard to get. Hopefully with my bigger screen, because I went back to my old method of recording, I can make the jump properly. Oh, come on, I did a failed ground pound. That sucks. Eye to eye in the secret room. Okay, just like the last level, all you have to do is go to the floor with... not to the floor. You want to go up here where Big Boo is. Wow, that was a fail. And, not that hard. All you have to do is grab the cap up here. Oh, dang it, I forgot. You have to go into the little balcony type thing inside, and then you have to speed your way up to, up there, or you won't make it. Trial and error if you're bad at the game. Let's Play Curse will probably screw me over. Let's hope not. And what doesn't make sense is when you're invisible, you have a shadow. Well, something's still there, but with how you are, you shouldn't have a shadow, but with how some invisible things are, you should have a shadow. It's hard to explain, but whatever. Man, did I really get hit by that thing? I did not want to grab that. Great. Now I can just go through him and he can't even see me. Wait, can he see me? Yeah, he can't see me. I'm just gonna stand in his eye, no big deal. God, dude, why'd you have to be right there? And I had to get health. Oh, he is locked onto me. That was unintentional. And we get the star. Here we go! Sweet. Sweet stars. Actually, we're gonna be visiting three courses. Okay, now that you have gotten the cap, the star, and Big Boo's Haunt, the last one, excluding the 100 coins, which I'll get at a later time, we wanna go back down here and we're gonna get another cap, but before we do that, we're probably gonna do a level inside that. So basically, to get this cap, it's a level inside of a level, and I'll probably be revisiting it. So, yeah. Also, if you talk to this toad, you get a star. I already got it. I showed it in the last episode. At least I'm pretty sure I did anyways. So let's get started with this next level. Swimming Beast in the Cavern. We are, after this level, we are going to get the secret star, which is the cap. Right there, you have to long jump or you're not going to make it. No ifs, ands, or buts. When I first played this game, I did not know how to long jump because I wasn't 100%ing it. I just kind of wanted it. I'm going to get hit by a boulder. No, I'm not. Never mind. I wasn't 100%ing it. I didn't know how to long jump, and I was horrible at the game. And it was... words cannot describe. Ah, oh, man, with me hitting that... crap. With me hitting that, I kind of ground pound. Oh, well. But with water physics, you can regenerate your health. Really like this feature. Okay, all you have to do is climb on the sea monster's back, which is right over here, and you want to ground pound on him. He in the remake of this, he actually looks like how he does in newer Mario games. I don't know why they didn't do that in the past, but oh well. All you have to do is, like how I explained like 5 seconds ago, ground pound on him, and where you face on his head, that's where he turns. Pretty self-explanatory. Actually, no, it's not. But yeah, here's that star, and we're gonna continue on to the secret star in that. Normally, I would just continue on through the level, but I want to get that cap really quick and get it out of the way because most likely I'm gonna forget it. So I'll see you guys there. And okay, guys, and we're back. This has possibly been my best recording session I've had in a while. Nothing has gone this great. Well, it has before, but nothing you guys have seen because I already explained this. Really sucks. But just like you did before, get on the sea monster's back, and you want to ground pound him just like before. Except instead of going into the middle, you want to go over here, and was it really that hard just to ground pound? That was pathetic. No, I don't want to go to the center. Come on, just go straight. Where you want to go is not right there. Wait, is it? No. Stop it. You want to... No! Dang it. Okay, let's try this again. Okay, what you want to do is go into the metal bars, and then once you do this, you can get... No, don't turn around. Crap. You can get one of the stars in this level, so might as well, like I said before... Come on. Yes, I made it. Like I said before, you might as well do this now so you don't have to worry about this. And just like you did before, go into this goop. Seems like sunshine all over it. Welcome to the Metal Cap Switch course. Once you step on the cap switch, the green blocks will become solid. When you turn your body into metal with Metal Cap, you'll walk underwater. Try it. You can also one-hit enemies, which is fantastic. Really, really nice. But main thing you want to do besides hitting everything is get 1-ups, red coins, and all the above. Okay, gotta hit the switch or you're kind of screwed. You've just stepped on the metal switch cap. The metal caps makes Mario invincible. But I thought it made me walk underwater. You're changing your words on me here, game. Now metal caps will pop out of all over the green blocks you find. Would you like to say yes? Why wouldn't I? Okay, before you continue on, the last 4 coins, you need the metal cap, or you're gonna get swept away by the current. So, yeah, they're all down here. As you can see, when I first came in here, I started getting swept away by the current. But once I hit the bottom, I was just fine. If you were a normal Mario, you're basically screwed. Right now, I should be screwed too. Elevate for 8 red coins. I hate this level. It's... Let's hear the awesome music that the metal cap gives us. It's not hard, it's just kind of tedious, especially when I'm commentating. It's really annoying, especially when I like taking these little shortcuts. It makes me look really bad and I shouldn't be doing it, and I make this way longer than what it should have. It took me 10 minutes on my first try on this. It was pathetic, but I don't have to worry about that, hopefully. So all you have to do is hit these arrows, and some of these boxes have red coins, so make sure you break them. That eyeball guy, just Mr. I, there we go. I always forget his name. Just kind of ignore him. He'll be helpful when you're going for the 100 coins. Crap. That's what normally messes me up. Wow. Failed triple jump right there, guys. Failed triple jump. God, I'm so glad they improved the controls on this on the DS version. Especially if you play this on the 3DS. Way better. So much better. And if you looked at the rendering, there's red coin in there, so might as well grab it, right? No, just gotta ignore it, right? Gotta better not fall right there. No, I'm not falling. What the? God, I hate it when that happens. Just over here. I'm not long jumping it because... Okay, yes I am. I should have just waited. That's exactly why I didn't want a long jump. God, that was stupid. Just there you go. It's not hard. God, I hate it when stuff like this happens. Old game, fantastic. Controls sometimes are a bit iffy. So, there's that dilemma. Hopefully, I can get my stars back from my failed recordings of... No, I didn't want to do that. From having 60 stars. Shouldn't be hard. It's actually pretty easy to get. But yeah, once you've... Once you've got all of the coins on this level, you want to go back up here. Ignore the elevator completely. When I mean that, you don't want to worry about the arrows. Well, you can, but... you can go around that rock right there, but I personally just like doing this. You can help yourself out by going like that, and I probably shouldn't have done that, but you can just long jump straight to the platform. And if I do this like 5 more times, just like my first recording, I'm just gonna cut ahead when I do it, because that was pathetic. Wow. Okay, maybe I do want to hit the arrow for maybe like half a second. That was stupid. At least it's nice to see I don't have any bloopers for this yet. Ooh, Wow, why'd I do that? I don't even know why I didn't long- No, if I long jump it, I would've overshot it. God. Can't do my fast, fancy moves here. That happened again? Really? Come on, I just gotta make it once. It's not hard. I long jump this all the time. Come on. There we go. God, that wasn't hard. God, that was insane. I hate it when that happens. If I fell right there, I would have been mad. Well, there's a platform right there. You can long jump over there, but I'm not gonna do it, mainly because I have to get coins. If I fell down, then I would long jump over there, but knowing me, I'll probably just fall again. So I'm awesome like that. No, no, I'm not. God, I hate it when that happens. Oh god, that red coin was hard to get. It's so hard. Okay, basically once you get that red coin, you can just fall off and then hopefully not fail like I did and just long jump over to the two red coins. Make sure these, crap, I forgot what these things are called. I almost said keys, but that's Zelda. Well, either way, this level is over. They start with a Z. No, they don't start with a Z. They're called Swoopers. There we go. I only know that because of Paper Mario. Why did I think they start with a Z? Zubat's Metalhead, Mario can move. Glad I got that metal cap. All I can say is, I hope the video isn't messing up, because on my TV screen, I just see it kind of bob sometimes, and I hope you guys aren't seeing the same thing. I really need a new capture card. I don't want to use an emulator. You want to... No, you don't want to go in here. You want to go in here? Yeah, you want to go in here. This maze, I can never tell which exit I need to take. It's either not that one. It's either that one or that one. I'm not entirely sure. I always mess it up. I never know which one to go to. So, if I pick one, I'll go to the other in the next video. Not video, take. Oh god, you don't want to go there. That's the exit that you don't want to take that doesn't lead to a star. Get out of my way, Swoopers. Actually, I think the one I want is right here. We just passed the other one, but I believe the one we want is right here. Don't quote me on that. Probably is, though. Not entirely sure. Like I said, always get these mixed up. It doesn't matter. They're both the stars are in the same exact place, so... Yeah. And there's the star. I hope I don't have a screwy camera angle and just don't happen to fall for no reason. Camera angle, you're not helping. If you're too close to the edge, it looks like you're still on this, you can still fall. And I wanna let go at A and fix my camera angle. But I'm gonna fall. Wait, what? Where's the... What the... Ah, crap. Camera angle, you like messed me up. I'm going to the wrong spot. Cause I think I... Yeah. Crap. The star's right there. Wow. Thank you. Thanks a lot, camera angle. Thanks. Let's not do that again. Hopefully. Why does he have to go so freaking slow? Like, really? Wow, I didn't even see- Come on! Mamma mia. I'm keeping that in. I'll cut ahead to when I got there. Wow. Okay, and we're back, and you now know why what I was talking about, when you're clearly on it, you just fall for no reason. This better not happen again. That was stupid. I hate it when that happens. When I first played this game, that always happened. There we go. God, changing your camera angle sucks on this. Here we go! Glad that level's over. And I was right, that was the wrong star. So, I'll see you guys there once. Okay, guys, and we're back. If you remember this area right here with all the swoopers, instead of going over there, you want to go right here where you see the moss or whatever you want to call that. The toxic fumes, I guess you could say. Seeping down from the wall. That's where you want to go. You can't really tell which one to go to. They're basically the same. But now that we got that star, we can go on to
Metalhead the Mario can move.
Okay. Fourth time. Third time. That was completely stupid. I grabbed onto the ledge and fell. That was... Oh my god. You guys have to see it to believe it. That was... God, I hate when the game does that. My god. That was stupid. I better not die right here. Okay. Don't get hit by the boulders. I keep dying in the same exact spot. That's so stupid. Hopefully I can do this a fourth time. Because that's really, really stupid. Oh, I can't ground pound on that. I missed miserably. Oh well. Okay, all you have to do for this is follow the path, and this is the fourth time I'm saying the same exact thing, and then hit the switch, and don't want to jump because that slows you down, and I also said that a fourth time, hooray. It's not hard, let's hope I cannot fail like a retard again. Finally, God! Was it really that hard?
Watch for the rolling rocks.
Okay, commentary just kind of crapped out. It's not even there anymore. So, I have to post-commentate this. I don't even know what the heck I'm saying anymore in this video. So, yeah. This is the last star. Every time I go by this, it pains me to see it because I know it's there, except I can't get it yet. Well, I can get it yet. But, it's the last one, and I'm doing this in order. So, there you have it. There's the last star. Now, we are going to end the episode off here. So, see you guys next time. Hooray, I'm wrong! Okay, what we're actually gonna do is, make sure I got the star from this toad, even though I did. But, I'm gonna check the castle, see if the second bunny appears, which he doesn't. Mainly because I don't have 50 stars. You have to have 50 stars for the bunny to appear twice. But with the second cap, the invisible cap, we can now go back to Jolly Roger Bay and get the last star. So, yay. It's not that hard to get, you just have to make sure of one crucial thing. It's the metal cap, not the invisible cap. I don't know what I was thinking. I'm thinking of a different level. We'll see in a little bit. So, yeah. Fire off into the distance. I'm assuming you have the cannon. Don't want to go to this area, mainly because it doesn't have the box. You want to go to that platform right there. In that area, I was completely wrong. Once you get the metal cap, all you want to do is long jump down right here, and you're golden unless the metal cap craps out on you. That's why I told you to long jump, so you can get your first furthest distance possible. You always want to tilt the control stick forward to make sure you get the star. So, off at that note, see you guys next time.